Hi everyone. In today's video, we're going to talk about Outlook. The Outlook email client is super popular, especially for work. And it's a really powerful tool for email, but it can be really easy to get overwhelmed by some of the features. So I'm going to talk about some features today and show you examples of how you can use those tools in Outlook to help you keep yourself organized and your inbox clutter-free. So if you've been looking for how to get your Outlook email under control, stay tuned.
So when it comes to using Outlook, you'll notice right away, first of all, that when I open Outlook, the first thing that I see is actually not my inbox. The first thing I see is this folder, which I've labeled Action. That's a folder that I've created for myself, and we'll talk about that a little bit later in the video. But you can actually determine where you want Outlook to land when you open it for the first time. You don't always have to default to your inbox. So how do you do that? First, you go up to File and Options. Then you go down to Advanced. And under Outlook Start and Exit, start Outlook in this folder, you would change it to whatever folder you want it to be. So if I click Browse, it'll give me what my folder options are, and I can have it go to the inbox, but in this case, I just choose the Action folder. So you want to set up folders first before you can use this feature. So I hit OK, and then OK. Then anytime I start up Outlook, it's going to default to opening this Action folder. For me, I find it really helpful to be able to look at my Action folder because when I open email to process it, usually what I'm doing is I'm processing the emails that I've already seen from maybe the day before. I'll talk about my email workflow in a different video, but I process emails in two separate steps. So let's pretend that I've walked into my email and I'm ready to start processing it. I usually start from the top down, and that's because I have this filtered in such a way that the newest emails are at the top. You can decide for yourself what makes more sense for you. Some people prefer to start with the older emails at the top and work their way down, or they'll start with the older emails at the top, start from the bottom, and work their way up. So it just depends. There's no right or wrong way. Again, it's just what works best for you. So play around with both options and see which one you like better. You can also manually move an email directly to a folder. If I wanted to archive this email, for example, I could drag and drop it into the archive folder, in addition to using the button at the top, which is something we talked about before as well. There's also a faster way to do this. You'll see up here at the top, I have this extra menu that says Move, and I can click this and select any folder that I want. This is really great if you find that it's most helpful for you to file things with multiple folders. I only use four, but some people have multiple folders. If you are an advisor for a student organization, for example, you might have one folder for each student organization, or you might have one folder for invoices and one folder for travel requests, one folder for budgetary information.
And being able to use this tool
will make dragging it to that folder significantly faster. As you're interacting with your email, you'll figure out what folders it makes sense for you to create. I only have four folders: Action, Read Review, Incubate, and Follow Up. And every single email that I process goes into one of those four folders. One other really fast way to get your emails under control from this inbox view is to just minimize the number of individual emails that you have to open. One way to do this is by using Conversation View. So if you notice, there's one email here that's actually the same message, and it's the responses to that exact same email, and it's all in three separate emails. So now I have three emails in my inbox that I need to open individually or do some type of action with individually. But you can actually save yourself a little bit of time by combining all three of these emails into just one. The way you do that is to go up here to View. And under Current View, make sure there's a check mark next to Show as Conversations. So if you click on that, it's going to ask you to confirm whether you want that to apply to just this folder or to all mailboxes. For this purpose, I usually just apply it to my inbox. You can apply it to other mailboxes as well, and that's up to you to decide. So then that email that was three emails is now one email. And if you find yourself wanting to review what those old messages, what those other messages were, they've actually just kind of been accordioned, and you can hit this little arrow on the side and it'll open up all of the other emails, including any replies that you might have sent. And it's going to show you in this instance, this is in my sent items folder, and that's just a response from me. So very quickly, it helps to cut down on especially any kind of conversation emails that you have. I find this especially helpful when there's a delay between responses sometimes, and you don't want to be that person who essentially hasn't read the whole email thread. So this allows you to just go to the last message in the email thread, and you can see the history of it without all of those emails taking up individual space in your mailbox. You can also change the reading pane. Sometimes people like to have the reading pane on so they can see in advance essentially what the email is without actually opening it. That's totally great. Definitely decide if that makes sense for you. I find that it is a distraction for me. I like the action of having the email open. It's just something, a habit that I have. There's no right or wrong way to do that. Just whatever works best for you. But you can have the reading pane on the bottom. You could have the reading pane on the right, or you could turn the reading pane off altogether. Also, when it comes to the reading pane, one thing I recommend if you haven't already is with this mark items as read when viewed in the reading pane. What this means is if you have selected an email, 5 seconds after you have selected that email, it will be marked as read. I usually leave this unchecked, even if I were using the reading pane. That way I don't forget an email and think I've read it when I actually haven't read it. So you can uncheck that. Mark item as read when selection changes, same thing. So if I were to click on an email and then click on a different email, that first email I clicked on, it would mark as read because the selection has changed. Single key reading using spacebar. So this allows you to not have to click on a new email. You can just hit the spacebar and it'll go to the next email, which can be really great if you're processing things, if you want to process things fastly, if you want to process things quickly. You can also change these columns at the top to be whatever you want them to be. If you right click on any of the columns, you can select field chooser, and it allows you to add a variety of fields. There's a lot of different fields that you can use. Address fields, post fields, which don't get used that much. Task fields, if you use tasks a lot. I don't use that much, but that's something you can do. And then deciding how you want this to be arranged. Maybe you want it to be arranged by who the message has been sent from, or you want it to be arranged by who it's been sent to. I usually default to having it be arranged by date. I think a lot of people do this, but consider changing the view up a little bit if it makes more sense for you.
So that's a little bit about Outlook and all of the tools that it has to help you get better control over your email management. Hopefully now that you have these tools, you can use them to really feel a lot more comfortable with using your email and stop feeling so overwhelmed by the huge number of emails that you're getting every day. There are tons more things that Outlook can do, but there's only so much that I wanted to show you in this video. If there are other things in Outlook that you found super helpful for you, drop a note in the comments section below, and that way we can share with each other. Using this and the other techniques that I talked about in my other email video, it should really help you feel more in control of your email and helping you manage your email so it doesn't manage you. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.